not a flinger.
All right. And we are live, folks. Welcome to the Sit Down Standard, the podcast celebrating all the amazing things you can do while sitting, whether it's enjoying movies, watching television, or playing games. I am one of your humble hosts, David Bray. I'm joined by a bunch of non-Powerball winners. Gerald Bales.
Hi.
And I won.
Oh, you did?
Yeah. No, I did. We won $8.
Oh,
no.
We won $9 in our pool.
What? You won $9?
High five.
Oh, man. We're winners.
Jordan Peterson.
Mr. Jordan Peterson to you.
And special guest, Charles Richardson.
Hey, how you doing?
Returning
I thought we went over
guest.
This. It's Chuck McGuck.
Chuck McGuck.
It's weird. It's been almost 10 episodes since you were on the podcast, so it feels like an eternity.
Is this our first return guest?
This is our
first
return guest.
First one willing to come back. I like that.
I know. Well, this is our...
beg the others, but they just don't want to.
This is our time.
They refuse.
It's somewhere on the list. If you get down there.
This is our 22nd episode, so it's going to be all about... This is our collector's edition, so we're going to be talking about all the things that we love to collect now, as well as kids. Well, when we were kids. Not that we collect kids. That makes it.
I wish.
Jeez. Whoa, take it.
I was not ready for this episode.
But we're also on Periscope. So if you're listening to the audio version or watching the YouTube later on, you can actually now watch our shows live on Periscope. And we have people commenting. It's going to be great. But before we start anywhere into the podcast, we always start with the same thing we start every week. With whatcha doing? Doing. Nice. Good job, Jordan. Thank you.
No problem.
So Gerald, what you doing?
I've been sick for the past, like, 3 or 4 days.
Stay away.
So.
Wiping my nose.
Yeah, I feel like it's a constant thing with this podcast. I think last time I said I was sick. Maybe the time before.
It's either Halo or you're sick.
Those are the two things.
Did you do anything fun?
No, not really. Got some new couches. Hey.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. Always need more, JB. Can't be happy. We're periscoping. And you're like, oh, we need to do it live
so
on YouTube.
Okay. Distracted. Anyway.
You don't play any, you didn't do anything? Come on.
I played some Just Cause 3 while I was sick.
Okay. So
but I talked about that last week. Yeah. Nothing new.
Okay.
But yeah. So boring. Jordan,
awesome.
Did we tell everybody we're on Periscope right now? It's listening to the podcast.
Yeah, I said that. I said if
okay.
we
I
are,
I literally just said it like 10 seconds ago.
I don't listen to you. I don't listen.
The problem is you're going to be completely distracted
to
this entire...
Well, I just yelled out to JV and I didn't know if anybody else knows why I did that.
No, people in the audio can be like, who's JV?
That's what I was thinking. So I just, you know, I'm talking to random people. Just
awesome.
So you guys all know. What have I been doing? I've also been sick, so that's
God,
been a lot of fun. But no, Shannara, I've watched the first episode like 3 times.
What'd you think?
And then I watched the third episode, or the first 2, I guess. And then I just watched the third one. Still, it's just getting better and better.
It is.
Yeah.
It's good. Did you get a chance to check that out? Chuck?
No.
Okay. Well.
Boring.
Well, you guys are really excited to start off this podcast.
Wait, we played some games this week. We did.
Yes.
You actually came
over
to my... I hosted a couple games.
You
did. That's right.
Which is nice. So we played Mysterium. And that was a pretty decent, okay game. I don't like the art games. Get off my lawn.
Oh, yeah, we got to do that. We'll get
okay,
to that.
I'll do that later. Anyways, so Mysterium, it was okay game. It's good for the audience. It seemed like everybody enjoyed it. But
yeah, it's a kind
it's
of a light
game.
It's kind of like Clue meets abstract art.
Yeah.
Right? It's cool. I enjoy it. I think it's really
like
good.
Did you steal the art? Or
no, so... Oh. Each there's basically a bunch of abstract art that have that has pictures of, you know, the person, the place that the murder was committed, and the weapon. And so one person is the ghost who was killed and is giving these other abstract art cards to try to give clues to the other players without talking as to who did it, who done it, right? It's an excellent game as far as... It's just super light, and there's another game called Dixit that's very similar to this where you...
Also sucks. I don't like games that revolve around abstract art, I decided.
You like strategy, and this game's definitely, like, super light, so I get why you don't like it.
What was that weird game with the cards?
The other thing
like
is there's this random chance of what cards you're going to get. So you get, like, 6 cards that have nothing really to do with what we have out there, and so then you're just like, whoa... There's a blue feather in this, and that room's blue. They'll get it. It's like, no, we're not going to get that. Like, ever going to get that. I don't know. So, I don't know. It just kind of... Plus, we lost, which I'm never a fan of losing.
We got pretty close.
We got close.
But, yeah, I think the one of the things about that game is... if
no
you're
gang
the ghost,
signs, JB.
if you're the ghost, it is stressful. Because if I don't... You know, because I was the ghost when we played. If I'm not doing a good job, the game basically breaks. So, I don't know. There was parts where I gave... I
Maybe
had nothing
that's why I didn't have any fun.
Yeah, let's blame it on me.
No, it was still fun. I had a good time. But I like Codenames better.
Yeah,
we played that
Codenames.
After. And Codenames is a great game. I just can't get over that game. It's really fun.
Yeah.
It's the same concept, but really fun. So, Chuck, what you doing? You been sick?
No.
All right, we got a healthy one in the house.
Sorry, well, I'm so sorry.
I went to Disneyland over New Year's.
Well, that's
way cool.
Yeah, that was cool. It's been a while since I've been, and April hasn't been a long time, and Dominic's never been, so it was really cool to get to take them for a couple days. It was busy. Oh, yeah, there's a lot of people there over New Year's. I can imagine. And they still had all the Christmas stuff up, which was cool to see, but I kind of wanted more of the Disney music, to be honest. You know, the Christmas stuff just kind of got like, all right, Christmas was a week ago, you know.
They paid for all that Christmas stuff. They're just going to keep it out till like February.
There was like another week of it. So we also put Dominic in flag football, so that's been fun to go watch. Like, I've been trying to help out Coach a little bit here and there. It's fun. It's really cool. He's that's the best awesome. One on the team. He's a little
of course
star.
You say that.
He is. Uh-huh. He scored all the touchdowns the first game.
Nice. Are you going to be one of those people that are like on the sidelines screaming at the other kids?
You suck.
No,
because I've been to baseball.
There are dads there like that.
You gotta yell at the ref.
Bad call. Come on.
Didn't you ref like a soccer thing for a while?
Soccer, yeah.
So you're okay with people yelling at the ref?
Yeah, like I remember when I first like one of my first games, one of the dads came. He's like, no, that was a different call, and I was like, I was only like 14. And yeah, so I was like,
how old okay, yeah, kids? Go the other way. Then I was like, wait, that's the dad for the kid that screwed up.
Yeah, they're ruthless. They take advantage of children.
How old were the kids?
They were like. Third grade.
Oh, so like really young.
Yeah, I was little. I was a young kid, but it was like a free intramural soccer league.
Yeah.
It was like volunteering. I didn't get
that soccer that everyone's in as a kid, right? Kind of one of those things.
Orange slices.
I wasn't allowed to play
afterwards.
As a kid, so I'm not familiar with the one every kid is in. But yeah, probably that.
You
one.
Didn't do that as a kid?
No, I wasn't allowed to play sports.
Oh,
it went Wait. With the holiday thing.
I think my brother and I were in the Clovis Boomers one year.
Nice. Oh yeah.
I remember all the trophies were like, as a kid, that was like the biggest deal to get that sick trophy at the end of the year. But
everyone got their little participation. Yeah,
now you
trophy.
Just buy a trophy.
No, I know. Yeah, I know. You have to actually buy one at the beginning of the year.
I think I got like a good, strong reader trophy once. It was pretty cool.
What did it look like?
It was just like a little.
Wait, a strong reader?
What does that mean? Yeah, like I flipped the pages, you're like, read well. Next page.
I think I read good.
Wow. Anything else?
No.
Chuck?
You gotta pass it.
You gotta ask me.
Yeah, he's like, hey, wait. Anything
David,
else
you
want to
not
say?
Just jump in.
David, what you doing?
All right. So glad you asked, Charles. I'm playing a couple of games on my PC. Remember, I bought a bunch of games on Steam. The game I'm playing that I recommend everybody check out, it's called Undertale. Have you guys heard about this?
Yes.
Really? You both have?
Yeah.
It's kind of an...
Yeah, it's on a lot of game of the year lists too.
Yeah, everybody's played this one.
No,
I haven't played it.
It's an old.
I just heard of it.
It's an old school, like 8-bit
RPG
where you,
Is it tactics?
Sort of, but it's interesting because you can play the entire game without ever attacking. Because in the game, it's very self-referential. It's very funny, actually. But you're basically a human that's dropped into the underworld where it's been sealed off. There's a bunch of monsters. There's a big war between monsters and humans, and the monsters are sealed down here. And anyways, it's just very, very self-referential, and it's very strange because you can beat the game without attacking. Like, one of your special attacks is to hug or to talk to them or flirt with them, and then you can like spare them if you get them to a point where they actually like you, like the monster. It's like, hey.
And do they join your team?
No. It's one of those things. Okay, I played it for like the first hour, and I was like, this is really weird. And
you got through an hour of hugging people? I've been like three hugs in, and I'm like, all right.
That's the thing. You don't have to. It's about...
You can attack if you want.
Yeah, you can kill everybody.
But what's cool is... there's a part in the game when you get further along and it starts making references to what you did earlier in the game. I love when games do that. I think Metal Gear Solid did that. Like, every guy you killed in the game later on became like an enemy. So if you went through the game and didn't kill anybody, then you would just... The mission would be over immediately. So it has a lot of that. But it's very... It knows that it's a RPG. Does that make sense? You know, like games that know that they're a game and then they play into that.
They break the fourth wall.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. So it's like, a lot of fun. And the mechanics of like when you're in the battle system, it's very simple. Like, you're a little heart, and then like think of like is it Galaga? What's the old school
Galaga?
Is it Galaga? Like, where you have to move out of the way for like it's called, I think, a Hellfire Shooter or Hell Shooter. I forget what it's called. Bullet Hell Shooter, whatever it's called. Tell us in the comments on Periscope. This is the best part. I can actually ask people when I don't know anything.
When he snapped my fingers, my wife disappeared.
Awesome. So anyways, I'm doing that. The other thing I checked out was I've been watching on Netflix Master of None. This is the...
Oh, the Aziz Ansari show.
Yeah, it's excellent. It's really good. It's super funny. It's basically... I mean, I talked to you. I think it's Parks and Recs. It has that same kind of...
I think that's just Aziz. That's just how he is.
Yeah.
That's his bit, his shtick, I should say.
But his parents are, his actual parents on the show are his actual parents, and they're hilarious. Like, they're awesome. They're so funny. But it's an excellent show. It's on Netflix right now. I think it's like 10
Sarah
or 12 episodes.
I think this show's funny.
It's like Louis to me. It's like, it's funny at parts, but then it's like, it's deep, and it has more meaning than just like your average.
Are the parents funny because they're trying to be funny?
No,
they
they're actually really bad actors.
Right.
But genuine.
Yeah, but they're
Yeah, but that's
now.
Why it's funny. It's like, and I think if you didn't know that they were his parents, then I knew that going into it. But if you don't know, you'd probably be like, wow, like really
some bad actors.
Yeah, but he makes a lot of like, the comedy is kind of like Louis. It makes jokes about like stuff that, you know, like he does an episode about Ladies and Gentlemen, and it's like a girl and a guy at a bar, and it follows two different storylines of like when they leave the bar, when they're at the bar, there are different experiences. So it's interesting, and it's quite funny. I enjoyed it a lot.
I really like it.
So I would recommend that. Okay. Now that we got through Whatcha Doing, now we can move on to the meat of our... the meat of our podcast. We're going to be, this is going to be our collector's edition. We were very excited to do this episode because we collect way too many things, and as kids,
what, you don't collect anything.
I know.